ومن سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له به طريقا إلى الجنة.
بسم الله، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. وبعد، نبدأ بكتاب الله، اقرأ يا إمام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، أما بعد، اللهم اغفر لنا ولشيخنا وبارك فيه وارفع قدره وللمسلمين أجمعين. قال الله تعالى، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. أحل لكم ليلة الصيام الرفث إلى نسائكم هن لباس لكم وأنتم لباس لهن. علم الله أنكم كنتم تختانون أنفسكم فتاب عليكم وعفى عنكم، فالآن باشروهن وابتغوا ما كتب الله لكم، وكلوا واشربوا حتى يتبين لكم الخيط الأبيض من الخيط الأسود من الفجر، ثم أتموا الصيام إلى الليل، ولا تباشروهن وأنتم عاكفون في المساجد، تلك حدود الله فلا تقربوها، كذلك يبين الله آياته للناس لعلهم يتقون. ولا تأكلوا أموالكم بينكم بالباطل وتدلوا بها إلى الحكام لتأكلوا فريقا من أموال الناس بالإثم وأنتم تعلمون. يسألونك عن الأهلة.
حسبك. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى: وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. It is a very important matter of aqidah here in terms of supplication, dua. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in authentic hadith, الدُّعاء هو العبادة. الدُّعاء هو العبادة. Indeed, supplication is the actual act of worship. Worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Supplication is worshipping Allah. And all the problems that appears between a monotheist and a polytheist, mushrik and mu'min and a believer and disbeliever, is in a matter of dua, supplication. Who do we call in terms of, in the times of desperation, in the times of need, in the times of happiness, in the times of thankfulness, this thankfulness, in the times of problems, who do we call for help and aid? Who do we face our dua to? This is what differentiates between the differs and al-furqan bayna. Hada huwa al-furqan bayna awliya al-shaytan wa awliya al-rahman. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah has a book, small risala called al-furqan bayna awliya al-shaytan wa awliya al-rahman. Awliya al-rahman, the allies of Ar-Rahman, the most all-merciful. We will come to breaking down the ayah, inshallah. But the allies of Ar-Rahman is the one who supplicate to him, asking for his mercy. They say, Ya Rahman, urhamna. They want the mercy to be continuous upon them. They say, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, irhamna. Ya Razzaq, urzuqna. Ya Latif, ultof bina. يا قوي قونا، يا متين أمتن قلوبنا على دينك، اربط قلوبنا على دينك. They ask him, they call him by his names and by his attributes, الأسماء والصفات. ولله الأسماء الحسنى فدعوه بها وذروا الذين يدعون من دونه. And leave the one that they call beside Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Throw it away. Don't go near it. So this ayah is important. And the sabab nuzul, this ayah, the sabab nuzul is that it is in Sahihain, Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, that we're going to read it in here. Subhanallah. روى الإمام أحمد and the hadith is in Muslim as well من حديث أبي هريرة and بخاري في الأدب المفرد معلقا and in many other books the hadith is authentic that روى الإمام أحمد عن أبي موسى الأشعري. We read the سبب نزول first. The reason for this ayah was revealed is that he said كنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في غزاة فجعلنا نصعد لا نصعد شرفا ولا نعلو شرفا ولا نهبط واديا إلا رفعنا أصواتنا بالتكبير. قال فدنا منا فقال أيها الناس أربعوا على أنفسكم فإنكم لا تدعون أصم ولا غائمة. أبو موسى الأشعري they said صلى الله عليه وسلم that was in the battle of Tabuk, that whenever we go uphill and downhill we say Allahu Akbar Subhanallah Alhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah loudly. They said arba'u ala anfusikum, take it easy upon yourself. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said take it easy, slow down, do not supplicate loudly. And this another evidence here for those Ahlul Bid'ah where they sit in a group say afdalu dhikri la ilaha illallah la ilaha all of them illallah until it becomes illallah illallah illallah, then it's all been really fastened. This is not dhikr. Okay, this here in hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said arba'u ala anfusikum, take it easy, do not harm yourselves. Innakum la tad'una asamma wa la ghaiba, neither you are supplicating to the one who is not hearing, neither who is missing to you. إنما تدعون سميعا بصيرا والله هو السميع البصير ولله الأسماء الحسنى. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى وليس كمثله شيء هو السميع البصير. He's all hearer سبحانه وتعالى. All sees, sees everything, nothing miss from him. ولا حبة في ظلمات الأرض ولا رطب ولا يابس. Everything, nothing misses from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So why are you shouting in your supplication? سميعا بصيرا إن الذين تدعون أقرب إلى أحدكم من عرق راحلته. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is more near than to you than the ropes that you're holding from your camel. He's caretaker. Allah سبحانه وتعالى القائم بنفسه والقائم على شؤون خلقه. He surrounds us. Allah سبحانه وتعالى He's surrounding us and He has ultimate power over us. So من عنق رحلتي قال عبد الله بن قيس يا عبد الله بن قيس and he told عبد الله بن قيس the صحابي he was with him and another camel he said to him don't I teach you, shouldn't I teach you how to get a treasure from the treasure of العرش in one narration and paradise. He said لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. There is no power and there is no authority in me that I could turn things around unless with you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you believe in that, then your supplication has to be all to him, not to saint, not to dead saint, dead trees, dead clothes or cloaks or hairs or swords or shoes. They bring us 2 meter long shoes and they say this is the slipper of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then they bring a size 8. Then one day size 12. Then they bring an alien, don't worry. And they say this is belonging to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then they bring in a horse tail, 2 meter long. And they say this is from the hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I have seen it with my own eyes. And it's all over the social media, subhanallah. All these things to trick people into submitting to them. So let's come back to the ayah. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي. They are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if my servants ask about me, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ, I'm near. But with nearness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's above His throne. In 7 ayat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirmed. الرَّحْمَنُ عَلَى الْعَرْشِ اسْتَوَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rose above His throne. They fabricate slander, they lie upon us, Ahlul Sunnah, those Ahlul Bid'ah from Asha'iras, Mu'tazilas, Maturidiyas, Shadhiliyas, you name them. They say, we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sitting above His throne like I'm sitting here. And they fabricated this, slandered Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah that he affirmed that. Ibn Battuta said that. And he's a liar. The time he said that, Shaykh al-Islam is said that, I saw him saying that in Damascus. Shaykh al-Islam was in prison. So they even say that now, that we say that. A'udhu billah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rose above his throne the way befits his majesty, unlike his creation. Unlike his creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after he mentioned so many ayats in Quran with regards to that, then he said, ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ ثُمَّ عَرَجَ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَسَوَاهُنَّ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ عَرَج, عُرُوج, it's going above. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the throne needs Allah. Allah doesn't need throne. But it's the part of beautification of his kingship. How complete he is. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is near us and he's above his throne. Because what apply on me as creation does not apply on the creator. If I'm near you, so most of the time I have to be really literally near you. Why? Because their al-aql al-qasr, their limited intellect that they have, this ahlul bid'ah, why they negate that for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because they comparing it to themselves. And they say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is everywhere with us. Look at this ayah. He's near you. Allah's with us. Because they comparing it to his creation. Only that applies on creation. And not all the time. How many times you have your father calling you on the phone and says, my son, go, I'm with you. Go, I'm with you. What does that mean? It means I back you up if you need help. Isn't that true? What Allah said to Musa alayhi salam, idhaba ila fir'auna, idhaba fadhaba ila inni ma'akuma asma'u wa ara. He explained, I am with you, I see, I hear. Did he mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is physically with them? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is higher than that. But these people, the ayat mutashabihat, you have to refer it back to ayat muhkamat. The one there is no doubt and second explanation for it. Ayat al-istiwa ala al-arsh. فَإِنِّي قَرِيبًا. He is with you. يَعْلَمُكُمْ, Ibn Abbas said. He is with you. He knows you. He sees you. Nothing missing from you. He has the ultimate power to stop everything or to make everything go forward with his knowledge. Why did we explain it with his knowledge? For three reasons. One, Allah's greater, higher than that to be with his creation in one place. Secondly, we have ayat that affirms that he is above his throne after he creates samawat and ard, thumma istawa ala al-arsh. And thirdly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has ultimate, if you have ultimate control, complete control over something, he cannot move and breathe or do anything without you, do you have to be there? Answer me, please. Do you have to be there? You don't have to. Say, that's for creation. What about the creator? You say, I am sitting in my office and I have total control over my company. I know what they're doing, what they're saying. I tell them to stop, they stop. I tell them to move, they move. Do this, do that. Whatever supplies they need, I send them. Does he have to be there? That is for the creation. What about the creator? Subhan al-Khaliq. So, Imam, Subhanallah, there's many ayat and hadith where Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, أنا عند عبدي ظني بي. Allah says this. Allah said, I am with the intention, the way he thinks about me. وأنا معه إذا دعاني. And I'm with him when he calls me. فَلِيَسْتَجِ فَإِنِّي قَرِيب. I am near. Why? To cut and omit and sever all the connections that you want a shaitan want to put between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kuffar Quraysh, they understood the monotheism better than many Muslims of this generation. Kuffar Quraysh, disbelievers of Quraysh, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, قُولُوا لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهُ تُفْلِحُ. Say, there's no one beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you'll be successful. You know how they understood? This man wants us to leave 360 idols and follow one. They understood straight away that this is the meaning of that. When you say La ilaha illallah, it means I call no one beside Allah. They understood better than Muslims here. They say La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. They say Ya Hussein, Ya Ali, Ya Abdul Qadir Gailani, Ya Sayyid Badawi, Ya Ahmad Fulan, Ya Sayyid Mahfuz, whatever in Tarim, Ya Fulan this, Ya Fulan that, Ya Shaitan this, Ya Shaitan that. All tawaghit min dunillah. Subhanallah, they understood better. They refused to say La ilaha illallah because they knew what the outcome would that be. They didn't do it. So Allah is telling you, subhanallah, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبُ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّعِي إِذَا دَعَان. I will reply and answer the caller of the supplicator who supplicates, performs dua if he, when he calls me. He tells you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is no middleman. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُ Let them answer to me, to Allah. وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي Let them put their faith in me, لَعَلَّهُمْ So they may be guided. It means this is the ultimate way of guidance in here, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, explain to people. Read this ayah for them. So they may not call others then, because Allah said in Quran, you come and tell me, they pray, they go hajj, they fast, they pray qiyamul layl, they are charitable, they kind, they believe in Allah. How can you call them mushrik? I didn't, Allah did in Quran. Listen to Quran where Allah said, وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ I didn't say that. Allah said, they associate partner in their action with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their worshipping. I did not say that. They need to understand that. Why Ibrahim alayhi salam, after the completion of Kaaba and destroying all the idols and breaking them, he said, وَجْنُبْنِي وَبَنِيَّ أَن نَعْبُدَ الْأَصْنَامِ نَعْبُدْ Because calling an idol, what is an idol? You could be an idol. An idol from performing what you're supposed to and what you've been asked. You can't. If you are not able and someone is asking you, in which belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you become an idol. You just become hubal. If you're a female, you become a manat. We have seen that. Or let's come to tabarruk. Tabarruk. MashaAllah, kissing the clothes, kissing the dress, and taking a wash, take all the virus and germs and feed it to your children or spit of sheikh. These things are not allowed, not permitted. It was not permissible for Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Afdalu al-Nasi ba'da al-Anbiya. Afdalu al-Bashar. It was not permissible. Only Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his clothing, his body, anything his belonging that he touched was blessed. Only him. No one else. I've seen shaitans with their stinky legs, they wash it in a bucket, and the children, students, let's have some virus, let's have some coronavirus from this guy. Subhanallah, and they spread in it. Or I've seen his children, he can't, he stutters, he brings it, he spits at his mouth. Hasbunallah, why your level of intelligence of people gone to that level? Where they do these things, I've seen worse. They leave the Khaliq, they go to the makhluk. And you see, wallahi, that grave, if a security is not there, dog goes and pees on it. And he cannot protect himself. I've seen something weirder than that. Either Rafidi, baklava head, turban, big one, sitting there in a wheelchair in a hospital. He's meeting a doctor. He has an appointment to fix himself. And lady sitting there with a child, toddler in his hand. Oh, Sheikh, please, can you read Ruqya on my child and make him better? Sheikh himself has come to the doctor for appointment. Where's your brain? And Sheikh does this, and he leaves. Yaqi, taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How are you not making Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala angry for what you're doing? And the ayat is plenty. Huwa ma'akum aynama kuntum. They read these ayahs. Allah is with you wherever you are. Of course he's with you wherever you are. If you look at the moon above, when you walk outside at night, is he with you wherever you are or not? Huh? Does that mean he's literally with you? Huh? Subhanallah, that's for the creation. What about for the creator? Taqullah, the sun, the cloud. Subhanallah. So, لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ وَقَوْلُهُ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in another hadith in Abu Hurairah, أنه سمع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he heard رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, أنا قال الله, حديث قدسي, قال الله, Allah said, أنا مع عبدي ما ذكرني, I am with my servant as long as he remembers me. It means I remember him. I look after him. Allah said to Nuh alayhi salam, فَاصْنَعِ الْفُلْكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. Tell me one thing, please. I tell you, for example, do the work, start the work. I'm with you. I'm watching you. What is the meaning of me watching you if that doesn't make you understand? I help you when you need help. Is that right or not? Otherwise, me just watching you alone, does he have any benefits? It doesn't. So we told Musa, Nuh alayhi salam, I'm watchful of you. And I'll look out for you. If you need help, I send you help. So, what does that mean? هذا نظر عناية ورعاية, caretaking, taking, I'll take care of you. Same is said to Musa عليه السلام. Same is said to صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبي لا تحزن إن الله معنا. Allah's with us. Or was Allah inside the cave? يا أخي اتقوا الله, if Allah is with you everywhere, he's with you in a bathroom. ها؟ اتقوا الله سبحانه وتعالى. إذا حلولية واتحاد. This is a كفر. This is a كفر, blasphemy. الله المستعان. Any questions? ثم قال الله سبحانه وتعالى, إمام قرطبي said, رحمه الله, وإذا سألك المعنى, إذا سألوك عن المعبود, if they ask you about the creator, فأخبرهم أنه قريب, يثيب على الطاعة, ها, ويجيب الداعي, he rewards for good deeds, and he answers the supplicator, ويعمل ما يفعله العبد من صوم وصلاة وغير ذلك, he is aware and knows nothing missing from him, from your deeds that you do, fasting, praying, performing zakat, let them not to go to other. فقال مقاتل أن عمر رضي الله عنه, this is the for the other ayah, inshallah, سبب نزول. أن علماء, they say from ابن عباس, فإني قريب, I am near, as soon as they ask me, I will reply to them, I will answer their prayer. And the prayer is between three stages. Prayers all good, supplications always great. One, either you will be answered immediately. Secondly, either will be delayed and will be answered in a right place, right time for you, which you do not know. This time you ask him for is no good for you. Ya Rabbi, give me one boy now. Ya Rabbi, this year Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you get pregnant, my sister, you become very sick. Many things, many minerals are missing from your body. You don't know, Allah knows. So he delays it for you till the next year. Huh? Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not answer because he knows if you get pregnant, you'll be worse off than not. He will, in substitute of that, for your dua, he will do something else in this life and will be reserved for you in a day of judgment. So dua is all khair. Dua is all khair. ثم قال الله سبحانه وتعالى أحل لكم ليلة الصيام الرفث إلى نسائكم هن لباس لكم وأنتم لباس لهن علم الله أنكم كنتم تختانون أنفسكم فتاب عليكم وعفى عنكم فالآن باشروهن وابتغوا ما كتب الله لكم وكلوا واشربوا حتى يتبين لكم الخيط الأبيض من الخيط الأسود من الفجر ثم أتموا الصيام إلى الليل ولا تباشروهن وأنتم عاكفون في المساجد تلك حدود الله فلا تقربوها كذلك يبين الله آياته للناس لعلهم يتقون. What was the سبب نزول of this ayah? The reason was this ayah was revealed. From the beginning, the fasting upon Sahabi was very difficult. very harsh in terms of human endurance. You allowed to eat and drink after Maghrib until you sleep. If you fall asleep after Maghrib straight away, and you wake up after 1 hour, after half an hour, you have no right to eat and drink. That's it. You'll have to fast until next Maghrib. And they have no time when they're going to eat, when they're going to sleep, when they're going to go to their wives. So some of the Sahabas used to, you know, go offside and go to their wives. They couldn't hold themselves. It's difficult. Yeah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah, and the time for fasting was prolonged until Fajr, from Maghrib until Fajr, from abstaining from fast. Then fast start from Fajr to Maghrib. This is was the reason for that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أُحِلَّ لَكُمْ لَيْلَةَ الصِّيَامِ الرَّفَثُ إِلَىٰ نِسَائِكُمْ. Because one Sahabi, after Maghrib, he came home. What do you have, dear wife? Nothing. Can you make me something? عَلَى الْعَيْنِ وَعَلَى الرَّاسِ. I'm going to do it. He fell asleep. She came back, said, مَسْكِينَ. He slept. Then he woke up. He's going to fast. Next day, midday, tanks empty. He fell. He fainted. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam found out. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, another reason for this ayah, beautiful ayah to be revealed. أُحِلَّ لَكُمْ لَيْلَةَ الصِّيَامِ أَرَّفَثُ إِلَىٰ نِسَائِكُمْ. What's the main purpose? That he said, on the night of fasting, after Maghrib until Fajr, it's permissible for you to go to your wives, to enjoy each other. إِلَىٰ نِسَائِكُمْ. Not any female, نِسَائِكُمْ, that belongs to you, your wives. Your wife, singular, or your wives. هُنَّ لِبَاسٌ لَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لِبَاسٌ لَهُنَّ. This is a beautiful ayah for the reminder that woman and man, they are equal of each other. They are equals to each other in terms of they are coverage for each other. They cover each other's shortcoming. Physical shortcoming, emotional shortcoming, financial shortcoming. They have to cover each other. Some women think man has to pay everything and she puts her money somewhere else. No, it's not. What is the meaning of libas for each other? You have to cover each other. You know, something you want to do, not because you have to. You want to do it because it makes the relationship more beautiful, more closer to each other, more much stronger. So they are هُنَّ لِبَاسٌ لَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, libas, meaning of cloak, cover. Covers everything, right? Covers from head to toe. Gives you comfort, gives you warmth, sometimes protects you from the heat, protects you from the hawam, from all these insects out there, from all the problems, from others to see your weakness. This is the definitions of clothing, right? So she is your clothing and you are her clothing. So you don't talk ill of her outside, to your family, to your wife, to your brothers, to your sisters, to your cousins at all. You cover her. You be protective of her. She is the same. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Aisha radiallahu anha, indirectly to remind her, he said, the worst woman in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one what's happened between her and husband at night, and she goes and tell her friends. You know, he was good at this, he was good at that. And you go, she was good at this, she was good at that. This is a major sin. So what is the meaning of cover is that? We have to understand the ayat. You have to literally be a protective layer for each other in all terms. Male to female. Female to male. عَلِمَ اللَّهُ أَنَّكُمْ كُنْتُمْ تَخْتَانُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Let us, عَلِمَ اللَّهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. Whatever hearts hides. عَلِمَ اللَّهُ أَنَّكُمْ كُنْتُمْ تَخْتَانُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Allah knew that you are going to, already knew that you are going to, but why Allah did not punish them? He knew that they're going to trick themselves. You know, they go offside. Yeah? They hit some red lines. Why? Allah knew that it's in their human nature, but they submitted themselves. Al-Muhim is you submit yourself. As it comes to the end of Surah Baqarah, the meaning of ayah, لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِنْ تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ وَتُخْفُوا يُحَاسِبْكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. Sahaba got disturbed. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would judge us for what we hide in our heart and what we say? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what he said to them, woe to you, do you want to be like Yahud that said to Musa, سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا, we heard but we disobey? No. Say, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرُ. Submit. They submitted themselves and they obeyed. Huh? And the ends belong to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reduced. He said, آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربي والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من الرسل وقالوا سمعنا وطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reduced. He testing them first to see if they submit themselves or not. It's all about you submitting yourself. Otherwise Allah has more mercy on you than you will have on yourself. That's why he was testing them first. So, عَلِمَ اللَّهُ كُنْتُمْ تَخْتَانُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ فَتَابَ عَلَيْكُمْ. And what was the تَخْتَانُون? Where was the small trickery? They used to go to their wives or sometime trying to eat and drink something. Yeah, you can't take it. You're a human being. فَتَابَ عَلَيْكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your repentance. وَعَفَى عَنْكُمْ. He will not hold you accountable for what you have done. فَالْآنَ أَنَّا بَاشِرُوهُنَّ وَابْتَغُوا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. الْمُبَاشَرَةِ, go to your wives from the place that you're supposed to. That's what it means. Huh? وَابْتَغُوا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا, eat and drink. وَابْتَغُوا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever he has granted you, has written upon you, from the blessing, seek it. Huh? وَاشْرَبُوا, eat and drink, حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمْ خَيْتُ الْأَبْيَضُ مِنَ الْخَيْتِ الْأَسْوَدِ مِنَ الْفَجْرِ. عَدِي بن حَاتَمُ الطَّائِي, he didn't know the understanding of this ayah. He literally took it. He sat until before Fajr and he put black rope and a white rope and he waited until he can tell the difference between them. Huh? It was not the eyes that the gray lion and the white lion that separates from each other. So you eat and drink until that time in Ramadan. Min al-fajr, until Fajr. And here there's masail, so much masail is going to be needed to explain. Subhanallah. Hunna libasun lakum wa antum libasun lahunna. Ibn Abbas said, wa mujahid wa sa'id wa mujahir wa ghayrim, ya'ni hunna sakanun lakum wa antum lahunna sakan. They are a place of tranquility for each other. Place of sukna, it means you feel safe, and a place of sanctuary for each other. Qala Rabi' ibn Anas, هن لحاف لكم وأنتم لحاف لهم. They are cloaks for you, you are cloaks for them. وحاصلوا أن الرجل والمرأة كل منهما يخالط الآخر ويماسه ويضاجعه. فناسب أن يرخص لهم في المجامعة في ليل رمضان لئلا يشق عليهم ويحرجوا أو يحرجوا. وكان السبب في نزول الآية أي حديث معاذ الطويل عن براء بن العازب قال كان أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كان الرجل صائما فنام قبل أن يفطر لم يأكل إلى مثلها. وإن قيس بن الصرم الأنصاري كان صائما وكان يومه ذاك يعمل في أرضه. فلما حضر الإفطار أتى امرأته فقال هل عندك طعام؟ قالت لا، ولكن أنطلق فأطلب لك. فغلبته عينه فنام، وجاءت امرأته فلما رأته نائما قالت خيبة لك، أنمت؟ فلما انتصف النهار غشي عليه فذكر ذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، فنزلت للآية وحل لكم ليلة الصيام الرفث إلى نسائكم وكلوا واشربوا حتى يتبين لكم. ففرحوا بذلك فرحا شديدا. حديث معاذ just explain, the man went home after working in a field all day. Do you have anything, dear wife? No, I get you something from her sister, from her mom, from her, you know, whatever neighbors. By the time she came back, he was too tired and he slept, and he could not wake up. He woke up Fajr, pray Fajr. Next day, midday, patrol all finished by midday. Then he fainted. And they said, Qais ibn Sirma al-Ansari, they said that to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah. And they were so happy just to have time between Maghrib and Al-Fajr. Subhanallah. And how much blessings we have. Wallahi, they did not have that much food as much as we have. We waste more food in Ramadan than a normal month. And it should be opposite. We spend more money in Ramadan than any other month. Most people put weight in Ramadan than any other months. Am I wrong? Subhanallah, it should be the opposite. Yeah, people, 11 months of ham. 1 month is two hands and two spoons and filling the mouth. From Maghrib after Taraweeh until Fajr, it's like a dual carriageway from 4 to 7 to kitchen, come back, kitchen, come back, kitchen, come back. Ya subhanallah, what is this? People take advantage of Ramadan for detoxing. But no, Allahi, I don't know. These great Sahabas, they were happy enough to be able to sip and drink something and eat something and have a good time with their wives. So they prepare the next day, work hard in the heat of Medina. If you lived in Medina, in the heat of Medina, it's like your head's egg and it's frying. It gets so hot. You look at the ground, you think sand's moving or steam is coming from it. It's really hot. It's like an oven. When it gets hot slowly, slowly, it doesn't get cooled down. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وفي لفظ البخاري عن البراء, same thing, تختانون أنفسكم ابن عباس, كان المسلمون في شهر رمضان صلوا وعشاء حرم عليهم الطعام والنساء إلى مثلها إلى القابلة. ثم إن الناس من المسلمين أصابوا, they made the mistake, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them. We just explained on all that. And حتى يتبين لكم الخيط الأبيض من الخيط الأسود من الفجر. In Ramadan, we explained in كتاب الصيام, in عمدة الأحكام, was it? أو بلوغ المرام. عمدة الأحكام. We explained that صلى الله عليه وسلم says, صوموا لرؤيته وأفطروا لرؤيته. Huh? You start fasting when you see the moon of crescent of Hilal of Ramadan, end of Sha'ban, and you breakfast when you see Hilal of Shawwal. That's 29 days. If you could not see it, then if you couldn't sight it, then you complete the 30 days. فَأَتِمُ الشَّهْرَ 30. This is what we do. When we start fasting, when we start breaking fast. Breaking fast, we start in is as soon as sun sets, as soon as the qurs, the circle, the eyebrows disappear. This is where we break your fast, not waiting for the cannon fire or Allahu Akbar, none of that. As soon as, and sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in authentic hadith, لا يزال أمتي بخير ما عجل الفطرة وأخر السحور. My nation are still in a blessing as long as they break their fast quickly, hasty, they're hasty in breaking their fast, and they prolong in their suhoor. And the wisdom of that is not difficult for anyone to see. You break your fast quickly, so you come back to your normal self. Have you not seen people when they fast 1 hour before Fajr, 1 hour before Maghrib, they fight with their own shades. They look for flies and mosquitoes to fight with. Isn't that right? You cannot, if you just touch them like they're a detonated bomb, especially if those smoke or those who they have sweet habits and all that. I've seen some, they break fast with smoke. Wallahi in Mecca. I gave him a lecture. There, I didn't let him go and eat. I made him feel so guilty. The guy was trying to open the ground floor and go inside. Yes, what are you doing? Subhan al-Khaliq. I said, you ruined your fast. I said, it's like you are going for Jum'ah and you're wearing all white and beautiful. And someone urinated there and you went just like a Peppa Pig and you went. You just jumped in it. Is that right or wrong? I said, this is what you done. Taqullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is fasting. In Mecca, in Haram, near Haram. In Medina, you know, around the gates of Haram is like a chimney. Wallah, I used to go there and no foreigners, all Saudis, people of Medina. I used to go there, you know, those shop owners. I used to go there and make them feel guilty, give them such a bad, make them feel horrible all the time. I said, is that the face you show foreigners that they paid, they gathered money all their lives just to come see Ahlul Medina? Is that Ahlul Medina you standing there? Is that the image you wanna engrave in their brains and in their minds when they take back home? Is that image of Umar ibn Khattab, Ali ibn Abi Talib and all these Sahabas you wanna give? I used to make them feel horrible. They see me from distance, they all run away. Or go back to a corner, go back to their shops. They're respectful. They could tell me, go away. But they never did. They know it's the truth. I said, me and you, we come here regularly. We know, I know you are regular. I said, but these people, there are many people, they save all their lives to come here once to see the inheritance of Sahabas. And that's you. So, Maghrib Salah, Ta'jeel, hasting is for that reason. And Fajr, Ila, you can eat and drink until Adhan starts. Not the first one, Suhoor, abstain. There's no such thing in Islam. Okay? First Adhan was for people so they can prepare themselves for Fajr. The one who wants to eat. The one who wants to renew, Bilal. First Adhan of Bilal was for that. For that reason, for people to prepare themselves for Fajr. You know, the one who wants to eat, have a last sip of tea, cup of tea, or have a drink, brush their teeth, or eat, or, you know, go to their wives, or take a shower. So they, when Adhan of Ibn Abi Maktoum come, Abdullah Uthman come, Abdullah Ibn Abi Maktoum, Abdullah Ibn Uthman, he comes, starts, you go to Masjid straight away. So, this is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Khaytul abiyad min al khaytul aswad is that which you see from the sky, which is the gray shade and a black shade are mixed with each other, are separated. This is the time of Fajr al-Sadiq, the true Fajr. And we have something here in UK, some of Ahlul Bid'ah, may Allah guide them, is they divide Muslims in Ramadan, where they tell people Fajr starts 1:30, where actually Fajr starts 3 o'clock. And they say Isha Atama, the darkness of Isha never enters for 3-4 months. So they make people not to pray Isha at all. They Maghrib, and they combine it with Isha in Maghrib time for 3-4 months. We have two answers for them, for these people. One, that it's been proven that Isha enters, but Isha enters late, later than 40 minutes later than usual masajids. And I've shown it to Mufti of Haram, and he agreed with that. I have a video of that. Yeah, I've shown it to Sheikh Wasiullah, he agreed with that. Yeah, I showed them. And they agree with that. They agreed with it and they said, you pray with that one, this time. He said, but that don't cause division. If they didn't listen, leave them. But he said, if you have a proof that the Isha Atama, the darkness of Isha, appears in a certain time, that's the one. And I showed them the pictures. And and all of them, Abu Ra'ad and Abu Abdullah and Abu Ziyad, Muhammad al-Arabi, and Abu Abdullah al-Biyadani, all of them looked and they agreed to it. I have a video of that. So time enters, you pray in this time. For the second answer is hadith of Dajjal, where sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said Dajjal come 40 days, and first day is like 1 year, second day is like 1 month, third day is like 1 week, the rest of the 37 days is like a normal day. Sahabas, they all worry about, they didn't say, what are we going to eat for this year? Like one day, 3 meals or 300. They said, how do you pray our salah? They worried about what's upon them to do the duty. They didn't worry about Allah, the provider. They didn't worry about what we're going to eat. No, Allah is providing for you. Worry about what's upon you to do and leave Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to what He promised to you. It will be fulfilled. Huh? So they asked, how do we pray? Our salah in one day is like 1 year. He said, فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ. Measure the time, the distance. This is how you pray. You pray salat of 1 year in this one day. So you, between Isha and Maghrib, usually in this time of the year, let's say for the sake of argument, Isha does not appear, Atama doesn't come, the darkness, it's all red. You give the distance, 1 hour, 40 minutes between Maghrib and Isha, then you pray your Isha. Rather than you combine them every day, and you disable one salah in the calendar for so many months. And that is the difference between people of knowledge who they derive from the evidence, and the one who, when you ask him evidence, he says, go to my website. It's like I'm trying to buy a t-shirt. Wallahi, this is what he told me. After I said to him, Taqullah. And now I don't know, he became a sheikh of Tariqa Sufi. Allah al-musta'an. Ghafran Allahu lana wa lahum. So Allah said, وَلَا تُبَاشِرُوهُنَّ وَأَتِمُّ ثُمَّ أَتِمُّ الصِّيَامَ إِلَيْهِ ثُمَّ يعني بعد دخول الفجر, after فجر that enters, enters, ثُمَّ أَتِمُّ الصِّيَامَ إِلَى اللَّيْلِ. اللَّيْل start, night start with disappearance of the brows of Maghrib. And this is our difference between us and Rafida. Rafida, subhanahu wa ta'ala, shaitan tricked them. Either in Ramadan, they find excuse not to fast. Their so-called sheikh give them fatwa. Go outside 25 kilometers and come back and eat. Yeah, and then you are musafir. That's what they say. And or they prolong it for them, so they hate fast. They say, until you see stars, layl starts only with what? Appearance of stars. And we see some people, they say, I want to be in a safe side. They break their fast later than the Adhan. And that is going against the sunnah of, and the commandments of Allah and His Messenger. Then Allah said, وَلَا تُبَاشِرُهُنَّ وَتُبْعَكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. And we said, اعتكاف. This is اعتكاف. What do you call it? اعتكاف in English? Doesn't have a... اعتكاف. اعتكاف. So for اعتكاف in masjid, you cannot go near your wife. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم explained that in many hadith in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, the last 10 days of Ramadan, that you become an i'tikaf, within the asr of 19th, before Maghrib, you enter the masjid, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to tie his sirwal. That means he would not go near any wife enjoyment. So sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is what you do. وَلَا تُبَاشِرُونَ وَأَنْتُمْ عَاكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِ. What does that mean? It means the one who has no intention of i'tikaf, he's at home in the last 10 days of Ramadan, he can go to his wife. Last 10 nights of Ramadan, he can go to his wife. Not a problem at all. He's not a sinner. Even if it's the last 10 days, it's a virtuous and all that. If he goes to his wife, halal is better than committing haram. Subhanallah. So yes, only for mu'tikaf. وَأَنْتُمْ عَاكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. In hadith in that, where sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his wife was with him, Safiya, in one matter. What is your name? Adam, Abu al-Bashar. Focus, please. Dr. Adam. So, وَأَنْتُمْ عَاكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. Safiya came, he was talking to her. Then he walked outside to lift her back to her room. Their rooms had no roof. Their rooms had no roof. Wallahi had no roof, subhanAllah. Not because they couldn't do it. There were castles those days, there were big houses those days. Before Islam there were. Banu Abs, they made a city for themselves. There were. But they did not want to live this life, in this life, that they were living forever. Three-story houses. No, they didn't want to. So two Sahabis, Ansaris, saw him. They hastened. They said, ala rislikum. Slow down. I am who I am, Rasulullah, and this is my wife, Safiya. They said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we're going to have a bad thoughts, assumptions towards you. They wouldn't. But he said, no. I wanted to let you know, إن الشيطان يجري من ابن آدم مجرى الدم. Shaitan is within the veins. That doesn't mean you possessed. It means he wants to find a place to penetrate and put doubt in your heart, and you'll be causing yourself sin. So we learn a great deal from this hadith is that if you in a position where people would might have bad assumptions because you put yourself there, you have to clarify. Don't tell me he has to have a hasnat dam. You needed a pee-pee. There was only pub there. You needed the urine. You know you have a diabetes, desperation, you can't do it. There was a pub there. You went desperately to the bathroom, came out of the pub, the brother told, saw you. Stop him. Or next time, stop him. Say, Allah, ya akhi, I went for the bathroom because I have diabetes. I can't hold myself. I use the bathroom there. Because you put yourself in that position. Or they saw you. They saw me with, for example, the white lady I was talking. Huh? It was a police officer in a plain clothes. How am I going to stop? How am I going to run away from that? Huh? Wallah, a brother saw me and they called someone. I saw him with a white lady, blue eyes, dingy, wearing a t-shirt and jeans. And I said, why didn't he say she was wearing a thick belt with a cuffs and everything inside there? So the brother called me. I said, Yaakhi, wallahi, I was a police officer. How am I going to run away from that? So they told him, there must be something wrong. It's not the way you think. So you have to explain yourself. You put yourself in that position, or you are in that position. You must, from this hadith, did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam have to explain himself? Why did he do that? Question come. Why did he do that? He did that so he may not allow shaitan to play with his brothers and sisters' mind. Your wife sometimes has some doubts in some matters. Explain yourself. Don't say, I am husband, I am King Dhul Qarnain. Nobody can ask me these things. Akhi, shaitan is there. Explain yourself. What's the problem? That does not make you less of a man. You're just closing the door for shaitan. So, masajid and i'tikaf ends 9th of 29th. Tomorrow's Eid, before Maghrib, you leave the masjid. And some ulama, they say, i'tikaf is only done in three masajid, Baytul Maqdis, Masjid al-Haram, Masjid Nabawi, Baytul Maqdis. Nowhere else. Amongst those ulama, Sheikh Albani, rahimahullah. But this opinion is odd opinion. I'tikaf is done in every masjid that you pray jama'ah and jum'ah there. Every masjid, i'tikaf, you can go inside there and you focus, you devote yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a devotion. Huh? Devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No play candy crush in masjid, I've seen. Mu'takifs, mashallah, on their mobile. I say, well, go home, ya akhi. He says, no, you know, i'tikaf, what is this? I said, if you sit, not commit sin, sit there and do nothing, you get reward. If you just sit here, wait one salah after another salah, you are as if you're praying all this time. وَلَا يَزَالُ الرَّجُلُ فِي الصَّلَاةِ مَنْ تَذَرَ الصَّلَاةِ Hadith Bukhari and Muslim, as long as you're waiting for a prayer in masjid, you are standing and praying all the time in between those two salats, as long as you know committing sin. So if you're mu'takif and go to masjid, do nothing, one wait, even if you fall asleep there, wait one salah for another, it's like you're day and night, you're praying your salah there. It's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's grace and blessings, vast. Barakallahu fikum. فلا تلك حدود الله فلا تقربوها. وس حدود الله ها ها yeah yeah what are the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No, the boundaries in this ayah is not to go to your wives while you're fasting during the day. Huh? Not to go to your wives while you are mu'takifs in masajid. Not to eat and drink. فَكُلُوا وَشْرَبُوا حَتَّى. Not to eat and drink and go near your wives while you are fasting during the day. And مَنْ لَمْ يَدْعَ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ فَلَا حَاجَةَ لِلَّهِ أَنْ يَدْعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. You don't leave in food in your drink if you do not leave the rest of evilness. I know people, if they are not fasting, they are less problematic than they when they are fasting. I knew my you know, from family members. Yeah, when he's fasting, he's beating all the children up. He is like a detonated bomb. I've seen him. Yeah, don't fast, I said. You don't fast. I said, do not fast. Give the money. And after Ramadan, fast one day there. While you, I said, you're killing these children. They are not able to fast because of you. She's not able to cook or do anything because of you. Don't fast, it's better. It's just like when Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah was walking by some Tatars and he saw them drinking, and one of his students says, Ya Shaykh, where's Amr al-Ma'ruf al-Nahy an Munkar? Where's the commanding good gone and forbidding evil? He said, these people, if they are sober, they're going to grab and kill all Muslims and rob them of their wealth. Let them stay drunk. He said, lesser evil, lesser the two evil. This man, I told him, don't fast, lesser the two evil. If you fast, you're causing more problems. Ajib. Wallahi, I know so many people like that. I know someone shot his son. Yes. I said, what is this? And the meaning of the hadith, وَتُصَفَّدُ الشَّيَاطِينَ Shaitan will be chained. It means big shaitans. مَرَدَةُ الشَّيَاطِينَ huh? The big demons will be chained. Otherwise, and as Sheikh Fawzan said, حفظه الله, he said, something very nice. He said, Shaitan will be protected. Ahlul Iman and Dhikr and Taqwa will be preserved from Shaitan. The one who they built a great bond and relationship with Shaitan already, no Shaitan will be chained from them. And a proof of that, how many Muslims do we know they don't fast in Ramadan? They don't pray in Ramadan. They still go nightclub in Ramadan. They still do the same thing or worse that they've done before Ramadan. So Shaitan is not chained from them because they already have a nice bond with them. Barakallahu fikum. Otherwise, if it would suffer the Shayateen, then people would not kill each other in Ramadan. Huh? People don't steal in haram in Ramadan. In Ramadan, in Masjid Tan'im, they borrowed my beautiful slippers permanently. Yeah, and unluckily could not find anyone to buy. I had to walk. Wallahi, by the end of Umrah with my sister, I was walking like a penguin. I did not recover for 2-3 days. Could not find, you know, in Ramadan, Ashr al-Awakhir, you don't find any shops and all these things. Oh, you see people everywhere. Wallah, the way I was walking, I had, you know, cysts and all, whatever you call it, under my feet. And I came back from Shahra Gaza at the back. The road's not really, it's all like rocks. I was in agony. So this man did not have shaitan. He permanently borrowed my slippers. Subhanallah. No, so it is the one who seek the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be granted that. So فَلَا تَقْرَبُوهَا, do not go near it. No, فَلَا تَفْعَلُوهَا, فَلَا تَقْرَبُوهَا, just like وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَةً وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. Do not go near. What does that mean? All the means, all the ways that leads to that, do not go near it. Do not go near the cliff and say, don't push me. Don't go near the cliff. Don't go stand on the edge and say, because one small thing will be slipping or be pushed down. So you don't go near it. فَلَا تَقْرَبُوهَا. كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ آيَاتِهِ. Indeed, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains His signs signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divides into 3 or 4. Commandment, prohibitions, miracle signs, scientific signs. Like history, he tells you what's happening from people of before, then you find out from ancient books, that's exactly what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. So signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of them in this one, is that his boundaries with his in his commandment and his prohibition. Linnas, for everyone, Muslim or non-Muslim, for everyone. La'allahum yattaqoon, so they may be conscious of Allah. And taqwa is by fi'l al-awamir wa ijtinab an-nawahi, fulfilling the commandment. And to the best of your ability, every commandment in Quran, in Sunnah, is tied to a ability. Tied to the ability of the person. La'allahum yattaqoon. But prohibition is not tied to that. Because prohibition is abstaining. Abstaining yourself. You can abstain. Stop doing that. Doesn't require effort, does it? But do that requires effort. When we say to Sheikh Adam in here, go and pick up these 3 chairs. Requires effort, right? When I tell Sheikh Adam, don't go near these chairs, does it require anything? It doesn't. It only requires you holding yourself, right? When I say, don't eat this big cake, that requires a lot of effort. Sah? It's not easy. Stay away from the cake. But if I tell you, don't touch this chili, easy, don't touch it. No problem at all. So, naam. 4 types is awamr, nawahi, awamr, nawahi, commandment, mu'jizat, signs, and the historical scientific signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where he tells us about the story of Isa alayhi salam and his birth and the actual reality of it, how it was. That made the monotheist, muwahid, Nasara is very happy. The muwahid ones, that they don't believe that Isa, Thalith Thalatha, was son of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He made them very happy. You know, when Musa alayhi salam, what happened, and the exactly story of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the detailed story, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him victory over Fir'aun, and Sulaiman and Dawood alayhi salam, how the true face of Jews came out, with how they were lying about Dawood alayhi salam, and they lied about, they were exposed, the exposure of them. These are all scientific truth. So this is ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ. And we said, الْأَمْرُ يَقْتَذِي الْوُجُوبُ وَالْأَمْرُ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ لا تكليف إلا بمقدور عليه والحكم يدور مع علته. These are all important to know قواعد فقهية, that there is no commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unless it's tied attached to your ability. صلوا قائما فإن لم تستطع فقاعدا فإن لم تستطع فعلى جنبك فإن لم تستطع فأومئ. If you can't pray standing up, you sit down. If you can't pray sitting down, is there another thing here that a lot of people missing? A qaida fiqhiya is important to know, that some people can't pray standing up all the time. But no, they can't pray standing up because of their knee problem. They can't go ruku' and sujood. But they can stand up for takbiratul ihram. Standing up for takbiratul ihram, first Allahu Akbar, it's a rukun. If you are able to do it and you don't do it, your salah is not valid. A lot of people I see in masajid, they don't do that. A lot of elders and youngsters. I saw him walking to masjid and for takbiratul ihram, I said, ya akhi, I saw you walking to masjid. What is this? I'm not a social worker, neither am a PIP officer. Why are you doing that to me? I said, your salah, you're not benefiting me. Your salah will be nullified. It's not valid. You have to stand up for takbiratul ihram. You must. It's a commandment from Quran and Sunnah. So people don't. All these details are important to know. That nahi yaqtadi tahrim. Every nahi, every prohibition, it's haram. unless if we have evidence reduces the sentence to a something that recommended not to do. Barakallahu fikum. نقف هنا إن شاء الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.